All right, how about some football picks? You guys ready for this?
Let's do it.
Okay, guys. Now, normally, you know, we do this on Thursday.
Right.
But we're doing it a bit late this week because, you know, Tuesday was such a big news day.
Right.
It's important for us to focus on, you know, what makes our country unlike almost any other in the world.
Very true.
Of course, I'm talking about the NFL trade deadline.
Yeah.
That was Tuesday as well. kidding, guys. My daughter has been beating the casinos in a landslide, though. We went 2-1 again last week. We are 20-7 on the year.
That's really good.
We've only got seven. We've picked three games every week. Got seven wrong. We're
out of
week
this whole
10 right now.
Week 10, yeah. There we go.
Yeah. So if we keep this up, though, I'm going to start a super pack. I'm going to start picking candidates. First game, Jets and Cardinals. The Jets beat Houston 21-13 last week, ending a five-game losing streak. Now, to be fair, the Texans are pretty beat up right now. Mm. But Aaron Rodgers turned back the clock to the days right after his family stopped talking to him. About 10, 12 years ago, from what I hear. He threw three touchdown passes against Houston. First time he's done that since November 2022. He told reporters he thinks it's because he started drinking water with cayenne pepper.
Huh.
And now he feels great.
Really?
I wonder how Jets owner Ambassador Woody Johnson feels knowing that he fired the coach and traded for Devontae Adams and all he needed to do was add some spice. Now, to be fair, Woody looks like he would combust if he ate cayenne pepper.
Oh, bless his heart.
He just, you know, he doesn't look like he's into spicy foods.
Not
to judge a book by its cover. Now the Jets go to Arizona to take on the Cardinals, who have been chronically underrated, like Almond Joy. While raiding my daughter's Halloween candy this week, it occurred to me that the 49ers are the Reese's Peanut Butter Cups of the NFC West, everybody's favorite. The Rams are Snickers. Big market, lots of name recognition.
Okay.
The Seahawks are, I didn't get to them because my daughter came home from school and I had to hide all the wrappers. The point is, it's time for all you grown-ups who say, I don't like coconut, to grow up and accept the fact that the Cardinals are in first place. All right, it might be a bit off track here. Bottom line is this, Cardinals are favored by one at home over the Jets, and here is the child's play. Okay, got your brand new shoes on. You ready? Jets or Cardinals? Who do you like?
Yeah.
Cardinals.
Oh.
By the way, she really wanted to show the shoes.
Her shoes?
Yes.
Well, they're fabulous.
That was her condition of doing it. I had to show the shoes.
And you gave her what she expected.
Yeah. All right, game two. Niners at Bucks. Nick Bosa looking for his second big win of the week. But the big win for the Niners fans is the return of Christian McCaffrey.
Oh, yay!
Head coach Kyle Shanahan told KNBR he expects McCaffrey to make his season debut after missing the first eight games with bilateral Achilles tendonitis.
That sounds like it hurts.
Translates to both of his Achilles were jacked up.
Ooh.
Now, you know who else is happy about this? All the people who drafted McCaffrey first on their fantasy team. Mm. After all, how much time does a guy need to recover from a condition that could jeopardize his career and lifelong dream so he can help your fake team win $800 in a league with three friends and like nine guys you only see at the draft? I mean, really, perhaps think of somebody other than yourself for once, Christian. Niners are playing the Bucks, who have been plucky despite losing their top two receivers to injuries. Tampa has lost three straight, but they've been competitive in all the games. They even took the Chiefs to overtime last week. Also, the Bucks still have a lot to play for. They play in the NFC South, where my back is stiffer than the competition. So they could still make some noise. Unfortunately, that's not a joke. That is true. But they're probably a little outmanned this week, and that's why they are 5.5-point underdogs at home. Here's the child's play. Niners, Bucks. Who do you like?
Really?
Bucks.
Oh.
Well, again, she's taking the points. You know, it doesn't mean they're going to win, but she's saying they're going to lose by fewer than 6 points.
Yeah.
All right, guys, final game. Eagles at Cowboys. Dallas quarterback Dak Prescott tore his hamstring off the bone last week.
Oh, ah, God.
And it looks like he's going to miss significant time. You should see Tracy's face. As if the x-rays today weren't bad enough, right? I saw a story that said now because of the injuries, the Cowboys may start tanking, which begs the question.
What were they doing before?
How would you tell? Cowboys have lost three straight, and much when I get into an argument with my wife, they're winless at home.
The best video ever.
That pretty much sums it up. See, you see, honey, you see, honey, it's not that you won the fight, it's that I'm tanking. That's why my wife's always right about everything. The Eagles, on the other hand, they are red hot after a slow start. They have won four straight, and running back Saquon Barkley went viral last week for this play.
Oh my God, it was amazing.
When he reverse hurdled a Jaguars defender.
Oh, that's amazing.
The reverse hurdle. I don't really have a joke for this. I just wanted to show the video.
I mean, it's phenomenal.
And so you know what? One video for me and one video for you, Court. What? Also, for no particular reason, here's Eagles quarterback Jalen Hurts.
Rue oop, my friend. Summer madness, baby. Yeah. Okay.
This was a video posted on his Instagram last year. I think somebody may have told him to cut it out with the thirst traps because there's not many videos on his Instagram anymore. We had to pull this one out of the archives.
Yeah. He is engaged now.
Oh,
so the young lady that they from the University of Alabama toned it down a little bit. I don't know.
I mean, that could be a reason, but they were, you know, been dating for a while.
Yeah, yeah.
They're recently engaged.
Hmm. And so she might have said, "Hey, sweetie, maybe cool off on the thirst traps a bit." He posted a slow motion video. He looks jacked, by the way, in a sweater.
In a sweater, my dude.
Anyway, the Eagles are trying to win in Dallas for the first time in 5 years. They're favored by 7.5 points. Here's the child's play.
Eagles, Cowboys, who do we like?
Oh! She is so.
And the shoes one more time. Whoa, look at those.
Can you show the bottoms?
Yes.
Oh, they're fancy. Fancy bottoms.
Yeah, she's got the gray bottoms.
Yeah.
So to recap, guys,
the
we're taking
to the red bottoms.
Yeah, we're taking Arizona, giving up 1 point. Tampa getting 5.5 from the Niners, and Philadelphia giving up 7.5 to the Cowboys.
Okay. She's 20-7.
She is 20-7. Do we have that Jalen Hurts video again for when we go to break?
I mean,
all right.
It's the music that makes it.
That was child's play.
We'll be right back.
It's the music.
It really is.